I want Mr. Modi, our Prime Minister, to have the same compassion you showed for the opposition leader Gulam Nabi Azad in Rajya Sabha, to just go down the Delhi borders, meet the farmers and resolve the issue, sir.
One BJP member, Haryana Health Minister Thiru Anij Vij, took a trial vaccine but tested positive for corona barely 2 weeks after, sir. 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 Sir, wait. Sir, if you really think, sir, the Prime Minister should be the first person to take the vaccine. Sir, naturally, sir, all your people will start taking the vaccine. Sir, you can't, I'm talking to you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Air India, sir.
He's keenly attending you. You are worried.
Sir, Air India only, sir. No private airline came to lift you all the Indians who were stranded in all the Gulf or any part of the world. It's our Air India. Air India did a fantastic job. And what do you want to do? Now you want to say, I would like to ask the BJP government, the India government, straight on your face. You say you are against corruption. You say you are anti-corruption. But who is your partner? The AIDMK is the worst corrupt government in the country.
அல்லல் பட்டு ஆற்றாத அழுத கண்ணீர் என்றோ செல்வத்தை தேய்க்கும் படை. சார், பொருள் இஸ் ஒரு அரசனின் கொடுமை பொறுக்க முடியாமல் மக்கள் சிந்தும் கண்ணீர் அந்த ஆட்சியை அழிக்கும் படைக்கருவியாகும். சார், ஐ நோ யூ ஹேவ் டு சே இட் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் ஆல்சோ. வென் த பீப்புள் சஃபர் அண்ட் கிரை அன்ஏபிள் டு பேர் த அக்ரஸிவ் சப்ரஷன் பை த ரூலர்ஸ், தியர் டியர்ஸ் அலோன் ஹேவ் த பவர்ஸ் டு டர்ன் இன் டு அன் ஆர்மி and deceit them. I think, sir, this will be very good for this time, sir. Sir, our great leader, Anigan Anna, said that tax the rich and pat the poor. But what is happening here today is in reverse. The government is taxing the poor and patting the rich. So the FM's budget for this year was much awaited, with much hope. In the wake of unprecedented global emergency. So the Indian economy, which was already heading towards a tailspin, saw an unprecedented collapse, and the nation witnessed a humanitarian crisis of unforeseen proportions. So the shutdown of economic engines sent lakhs of workers on the long walk home, and many perished. So the incomes of salaried classes saw deep cuts, and a lot of people lost their job. So crores of Indians' livelihood and aspirations are snuffed out. So it is said that more than 30% of MSMEs have reportedly closed down permanently. Critics fear that true numbers may be much higher. Estimates say that 6.47 crores Indians dropped out of their labour force. Of them, 22.6% were women. Critics fear that true numbers may be higher. So in such grim circumstances, the nation was waiting for a revival package that give us a shot in the arm. Sir, of course, sir, we had the finance minister and the minister for state for finance come frequently in the television, like snake charmer. And so you've seen the snake charmers in the roads. There'll be a mongoose and a snake. And throughout that, the snake charmer will say, the mongoose is going to fight the snake and kill the snake, but it'll never happen. The same thing, sir, in fact, the finance minister and the state finance minister, they were just rewording and reallocating the funds which was there. But sir, in reality, nothing much had come down to the people. Sir, this budget was touted as an unprecedented budget. True, sir. It's an unprecedented letdown budget, sir. As far as the common man is concerned, once again, left with nothing but empty words and unfulfilled promises. Sir, there's no income tax concession. Sir, when in this pandemic, sir, the temples were closed. The churches were closed. The mosques were closed. Sir, the middle class people, whom we all are, sir, they were expecting something. They lost their jobs. They're sitting at home, expecting some benefit from the thing. Sir, in this budget, the finance minister never even mentioned that some tax will be reduced, which will be a good news for the thing, for the middle class, sir. Sir, again, sir, there's no clarity from the government on sector-specific revival packages. I don't think so. I feel, sir, they think one size fits all and they can just announce it. Sir, look at the aviation, tourism and hospitality industry. They are the worst hit. Sir, I know so many people who are in the tourism industry had gone to literally close down. Sir, especially your Kerala, which is mainly dependent on tourism. Sir, because of the pandemic, the entire tourist industry has gone down. Sir, what have the government done for that? So government should have come because they are built of resorts, they are built of hotels, and travel agents who have only income is only on the commission which they get on the booking ticket. Sir, they are literally on the road. For nearly for 11 months, they have not seen any income. They don't even have a turnover of one rupee, sir. This is how it is there, sir. Sir, probably, sir, the government didn't want to touch the aviation sector, the tourism sector, because if they have to infuse funds, then they have to infuse funds for Air India. That means Air India might revive. So because then Air India may not be sold. So for that reason, sir, they have not done it. Sir, look at the construction industry. Sir, in a hurried haste, they came and said all the construction should be stopped. All the construction workers had to walk and travel. So they said now that they are going to have a data bank of how many construction workers are there. Till now, sir, they don't have the data of how many construction workers, the migrant workers, who died walking to go back to home because without food. Sir, incomes are down. The common man is feeling the pinch everywhere, sir. Sir, but they refuse to reduce the GST. This is a time they should come forward and reduce the GST on all products. Sir, including, sir, they increase the price, excise on petrol. Sir, first time in the world because of the pandemic, the fuel, oil, global prices fell down to $23. Sir, they never decrease the price. Instead, this is the only government which increased the excise. And during the pandemic, COVID pandemic, the prices of the fuel shot up. Sir, even now, in 2014, the NDA opposition went on the roads and the prices of the petrol was 70 rupees. Sir, and that time, the price of a barrel was $140. Today, sir, the price is 89. Not a word from them. At least they can reduce the excise, sir. Sir, for everything, they quote the UPA. Why can't they quote the UPA now? Sir, the difference... we are in the middle of an extreme tension with China. Sir, but your budget barely even breached the situation expense that will raise out it. The figures of the defense spending barely shows any change. Sir, we are worried. Sir, at rupees 3,47,888 crores, it is only marginally higher than 3,43,822 crores in the current year. Sir, what is this, sir? We are in a war situation. We have to give strength. We have to get financial strength. We have to make sure that armies are well armored and able to protect our country. Sir, do you take our lives, our jawans, very simply, sir? You think by just putting them and before they are there, we can win war? Sir, we have to fund them. I'm very surprised that they are not funding the army the way it needs. Sir. Sir, the budget allocation for Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has been slashed by 8.5% in 2021-22. The flagship PM Kisan scheme meant to provide income to support farmers has a 13% drop in the budget, 10,000 crore lower than last year's initial allocation. You keep claiming that you will double the farmers' income. How do you propose to do this, sir? What is stopping you from implementing the recommendation of MS Swaminathan's report? You have sir, to top it all, the farmers are already suffering. You have increased the cess on diesel, which is the farmers' depend, sir. Sir, I should say, sir, with all due respect, when yesterday I saw our Honorable Prime Minister speak at the farewell speech for Ghulam Nabi Azad. Sir, Ghulam Nabi Azad is the leader of opposition, of belonging to the opposition Congress party. Sir, the PM did shed a tear, sir. I saw a lot of compassion because we never thought the PM had compassion. Sorry, sir, I've ignored. Sir, why can't you have the same compassion, Mr. Prime Minister, towards the farmers? It's going to be 3 months. It's going to be 90 days. The farmers are suffering. Swachh Bharat is out there. They are defecating the open. Sir, why can't the Prime Minister? We need that Prime Minister. Can we see that Prime Minister? I want Mr. Modi, our Prime Minister, to have the same compassion he showed for the opposition leader, Ghulam Nabi Azad, in Rajya Sabha, to just go down the Delhi borders, meet the farmers, and resolve the issue, sir. Sir, again, sir, you have touched the health expenditure sector budgets as a game changer. Sir, they call the health budgets as a game changer. For the very first time, they have proudly claimed the health budgets is increased 137% from 94,452 crores to 2,23,846 crores in the next year. Sir, the devil is in the details. Let's go and add up. You have simply add up the one-time cost of vaccination program, which is 35,000 crores.
funds allocated for drinking water and sanitation program and the finance commission grant for the states for water and sanitation and health, that is around 49,240 crores, to your actual estimate of 2021-22. The real estimate for 21-22 is only a little below 75,000 crores. If you take away all these other funds, which is lesser, sir, technically, sir, which is the health funds allocated to the health sector is lesser than, sir, what they allocated earlier, previous year, which was 82,445 crores. You have provided 35,000 crores for vaccines. Who are these companies? They are benefiting from your spending. Have you used any of the government infrastructure to help to produce a thing? Sir, I request the Honorable Finance Minister to come up with a forensic audit of these companies, because we need to know the government, nearly 35,000 crores are going for these companies. This doesn't have any backdoor entries to any political party, sir. This is a humble request, sir. Sir, at the same time, I would like to ask you, sir. Sir, competition is good. Sir, Pfizer came to India. Sir, all these two vaccines are not given the third full sample test. They are not done their procedures properly, sir. And the efficacy is only 75%. Pfizer came, sir. Pfizer was threatened. That's what the papers report. They went back. Why can't you have multiple vaccines? Anyway, we are not, Indian government does not manufacture the vaccine. We are only good. Why can't we have Moderna, which has got 90%, 95% efficacy, which should be good for it. So more companies coming to India, we can end this pandemic very fast, sir. Sir, at the same time, I also have a question and I have a doubt. When you are focusing so much on the corona pandemic virus vaccine, please ensure that you do not, the regular programs do not get a backseat, and most important, our children do not get the proper vaccination on this. Sir, again, sir, sir, when you're talking about the vaccine, I like to always say, sir, people, there's a discomfort. People are not truly trusting the vaccine. There's a little bit. Sir, because of the efficacy, sir, to prove that the vaccine is good, sir, in US, the president-elect Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris have taken a shot in public. Sir, similarly, in UK, the Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip took the vaccines. Sir, PM Modi's good friend, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, took the vaccine, sir. Sir, Indonesian President Joko Widodo took the vaccine, sir. Sir, in India, on the other hand, one BJP member, Haryana Health Minister Thiru Anij Vij, took a trial vaccine but tested positive for corona barely 2 weeks after, sir. Sir, 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 wait. Sir, I think, sir, our Prime Minister likes the American model. He always tries to imitate or try to replicate whatever the America is doing. And he has all advices from here. I think, sir, it is a serious time, serious note. The President of India, the Prime Minister of India, the Home Minister of India, and the Defense Minister should go out in public, and including our Minister for State for Finance, and take a shot, take the vaccine shot. This might give a confidence to our people. If you really think, sir, the Prime Minister should be the first person to take the vaccine. Sir, naturally, sir, all your people will start taking the vaccine. The vaccine process will be completed faster, sir. This is one of my requests which I make. Sir, this is without no political agenda, because I really want a country, a people of country, to be protected, insulated against the COVID vaccine. I'm sure the House will agree with me, sir. Sir, again, sir. Sir, there's one more issue which I feel. The corona period, sir. We saw a lot of packages being announced. Sir, as I said, the snake charmers, our finance minister and our minister of state, were announcing rebottling the existing budget and selling to public. Sir, can you give us a white paper on the results of your economic package? Shouldn't you present to the House that this is what we announced and this is what we did? And can you also say how many companies availed the schemes you assured and promised? Sir, can you also say how many individuals availed, sir? Sir, and also audit the expense and say to the, sir, has been any analysis done? Yeah, you have any data to, sir? Sir, I can't see. I'm not wearing a mic. I don't understand anything. Sorry. Sir. Why should I? I'm here. PSU have failed miserably, sir. Sir, they failed. Now they are in a spree to sell a PSU. Sir, every time they want to sell, why can't you cut down on your advertisements? Crores and crores of money you are spending to keep the media shut. Why can't you now put those money into our PSUs? Sir, look at BSNL. Sir, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, you assured the House that BSNL will be given 4G. Sir, this is 1 year back. Till now, sir, 4G has not been allocated to a BSNL. Sir, now the other companies have been given 5G, sir. Sir, one thing I will ask. Sir, our Prime Minister was a poster boy for a private company, Jio. Sir, shouldn't the Prime Minister take the lead and ensure be a poster boy and be for BSNL, sir? Won't BSNL do it better, sir? Sir, BSNL is loss making. Sir, now, sir, second biggest fuel retailer, sir, is BPCL, sir. But the petroleum minister goes on record to say, government has no business to be in business. Sir, what is this? 4,000 crores was given by BPCL to build the Patel statue. That time he never realized that he has to take the money from there, sir. Sir, look at LIC, sir. Sir, it's the only government-owned life insurance company and you plan to sell it off. Sir, as well off to fund your government. Not just that you are okay with allowing foreign players. Sir, there's a, sir, right now in WhatsApp, this is the biggest joke. What they say? There's a popular saying that if you are worried about your future, you should invest in LIC. Today, people are worried about the future of LIC, sir. Sir, look at Air India's disinvestment, sir. Sir, I'll ask, sir, I need your attention, sir. Sir, you can't, I'm talking to you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Air India's, sir.
He's keenly attending you. You are worried.
Sir, Air India, sir. You want saying that Air India is financial trouble? Air India has to be sold because of loss making. Sir, the house is not in order, sir.
Yes, yes. Sir, please, Bagalji.
Sir, you are saying Air India is in very bad shape. We can't rescue it. We have to sell it. Sir, who came to your rescue in the time of pandemic? Sir, Air India only, sir. No private airline came to lift you all the Indians who were stranded in all the Gulf or any part of the world. It's our Air India. Air India did a fantastic job. And what do you want to do? Now you want to sell. Sir, similar situation happens. Where will you go? Which private airline will you go and fall for the feet? Sir, do understand that, sir. Your policies are all fault. Sir, our Prime Minister last year said that in a country of 130 crores, only 1.5 crores people are paying tax. That is less, that is nearly 1%. Sir, let me tell you, sir. The 1% may be paying income tax, but, sir, the 99% are paying taxes. Sir, indirect taxes, sir. Who's paying, sir? Even if I buy a slipper, I'm paying a tax, sir. Even if I buy anything, sir, even if a woman buys a bindi, she's paying taxes, sir. Sir, we are, and the entire money, sir, the government is estimated to spend 34,83,236 crores during 2021. Of this, nearly a third of money is coming from indirect tax. Sir, collected from the 99% whom the Prime Minister says are not contributing to the tax. Sir. The total indirect tax collections are estimated to be 2,000 crores in 2021-22. Of this, government is estimated to raise 30,000 crores from GST. Who you think is paying the taxes, sir? Sir, it's a common man, sir. Every time the common man is squeezed and squeezed and squeezed to pay tax, sir, and he bleeds, sir. Sir. Sir, I would also like to say, sir, we are talking about digital payments, sir. Sir, I would like to ask, sir, when there's no interest, sir, the banking system is all digitalized, we have a system where everything, sir, but sir, that all hidden charges. When you ask me to go digital, there's a hidden charges. Sir, have you addressed the issue? Have you made it simple for us? We have not done anything. Sir, at this time, in this budget, has not addressed a serious question of job creation. Sir, the job, this is very important, sir, if it is not there. Sir, I'll also ask you, sir, this budget is not for the common man, sir. Sir, I was surprised, and also, sir, probably the finance minister thought she has to boost the automobile sector when she says that all public vehicles should be destroyed in 10 years and private vehicles in 15 years. Sir, I was thinking, sir, is there any logic? Sir, we are a poor country, sir. And in small, middle-class people have vehicles which they run for public and trucks owners, which they own, which is become public vehicle. Sir, these trucks have been engine have been renewed or been a new engine and put and they run for 15 to 20 years. Sir, please really look into the policy. Please do not ape American policies because of your American advisors there. Sir, the biggest announcement for them is that FDI flowed during the pandemic. They said FDI flows into India 13% growth of 57 billion. It's a sign of confidence world in India's economic potential. And that will boost our industries. Sir, what are they talking about, sir? Where did they... I'm the only speaker, sir. So where did the FDI come, sir? Sir, while the nation suffered job losses and incomes dropped of historic proportions pandemic, India's billionaires report a rise of 33% of their combined wealth during the same period, sir. Forbes has said this, sir. The super rich of the nation were getting richer
even when the economy itself was shrinking by almost a tenth, sir, the economist, sir. Sir, while India, millions of Indians job, lost their jobs into poverty, the fortune of our country's two richest, sir, Adani, sir, whose rich spoils from ports to coals to airports, mines to food, his personal wealth grew more than double to some $32 billion, sir. Sir, next is the big man, Mr. Ambani. Empire sprawling across oil, refining, telecoms and retail, among other things, sir, have grown to by 25% to $75 billion, sir. Let me not talk about Anil Agarwal, sir. Also, sir, the share of the wealth of income going to the top 1% of the year was 21.4% of earnings, according to the World Inequality Database. Sir, Credit Suisse, a bank, puts their share wealth at 39%, well ahead of the richest 1% of Americans or Chinese. These are Indians, sir. Are Indians, sir. Chinese. And here's the worst part of it, sir. The question is that, listen to the scathing indicted The Economist. Most alarming in India is some of the rich have become super rich by using their heft to crush smaller competitors and thus corner multiple chunks of the economy. The tilt in fortune has rewarded not so much technical innovation or productivity growth or the opening of new market as wielding of the political influence and privilege access to capital to capture the power. Sir, that's a fact, sir. Sir, these people, they never created any new product. Sir, they used their political closeness with the BJP government, with the NDA government to make so much, sir. Sir, we should be careful, sir. There are two kinds of people living in India. One, the super rich and the super poor. Please, sir, please make sure that you do not ignore them. And they are the ones who voted for you, sir. Sir, I should, in this scheme, sir, I would like to say, sir. Sir, I'm happy to, sir, first time, sir, I'm very happy because of the elections. The finance minister has made some announcement for Tamil Nadu, sir, after neglecting Tamil Nadu for nearly 8 years, sir. Sir, but when you make announcement for my state, sir, I don't take you very seriously, sir. I take you with a pinch of salt because nothing has materialized in my state, sir. Sir, how can we believe that when you promised 3,500 kilometers of roads in Tamil Nadu? Look at your old promise. Sir, AIIMS was supposed to come in Tamil Nadu and Madurai. Yeah, inauguration happened. Till now, sir, there's not a stone put there, sir. This is only a PR stunt, sir. Sir, you say special capital expenditure to 5 lakh to 5 to 5. Sir, this is very important, sir. Sir, finance minister says that the government is going to spend money on capital expense. And they're going to spend 5,54,236 crores on capital expenditure. But what do you do? You take away 7,900 crores of our MP lad schemes. How can you micromanage? What do you know? What my constituency will? You want to build a 20,000 crore parliament and a house for the prime minister and the vice president of India. But you don't want to build a toilet in my constituency. All your BJP MPs are asking the same question. Sir, is this a time for a new parliament or new parliament MP, prime minister's house? Sir, yes. Sir, I have a couple of things which I have
please,
to say.
Please, sir.
I'm concluding, sir.
Please.
Sir, the railway, sir. Sir, there's an elephant gate bridge in Tamil Nadu, sir, which is in my constituency, which is connecting North Chennai versus Central Chennai, sir. From 2016, there has been closed and the construction works have begun. It's been 5 years, sir. Till, sir, in 2019, I myself personally went and had a witness. We started the work, sir. Work is going snail speed. Sir, please, I request the railway ministry to look into it, sir, and do something about it. And similarly, sir, there's a long demand from our train for Jodhpur from Central Chennai to Rajasthan for every day, sir. Sir, this is a basic concern of Rajasthani people, sir. And during the election, sir, BJP committed with all the Hindi-speaking people to canvass for votes. But after they canvassed for votes, they never did anything, sir. But I'm the MP, yes. And I think we should do it, sir. I think we should do it. Sir, I should say, sir, in this, sir, before
now
I conclude,
concluding remarks.
Three points. Sir, right now, sir, condition of Tamil Nadu, sir. Tamil Nadu GDP has fallen by 38% over the last 9 years. Because the corrupt ADMK rule, sir, dropping from 13.12% in 2010-11 to 8.03%. Sir, the per capita income rate of Tamil Nadu shrunk by 40% in the last decade, reducing to 12.9%. Sir, under ADMK, sir, each citizen is forced to pay nearly 5,000 annually towards interest payments and loans taken by the state government, sir. Sir, my leader, M.K. Stalin, has time and again reminded the central government, sir, to look into issues and make sure, sir, sir, one finds hard to believe. I would like to ask the BJP government, the NDA government, straight on your face. You say you are against corruption. You say you are anti-corruption. But who is your partner? The AIDMK is the most worst corrupt government in the country. Let's talk about the past.
No, you can reply.
Former minister.
Sir.
Yes, minister.
Rather than giving anything to the BSNL, they have exchanges at their residence. So we know who has done what in the past.
Yes.
The country knows that.
Country will know that. Country will know that. In May, we'll tell you what people of this will not think. Sir, during the demonetization, sir, one person named a person, 2,000 rupees fresh notes for nearly 130 crores was taken, seized by the CBI. Sir, but your CBI has closed this case. They raided, yes. They took 120 crores, but today they say there's no evidence.
Saugodrai ji, please.
Sir, just last.
Concluding sentence.
Sir, never in the history, there's been a CBI raid in the secretariat. The Tamil Nadu secretariat, they have been raided, sir. People close to the chief minister have been raided. CM said there's a case against chief minister, sir, and the health minister. Sir, the corruption has taken place even in purchase of masks, for COVID masks. See, the COVID money has been abused and misused by the ADB government. Sir, till now, sir, the BJP government seems to be close, be blind towards Tamil Nadu. Sir, let me warn you. People will teach them a lesson. The people teach the ADMK a proper lesson in the coming election.
Mr. M.K. Stalin is
going to be the chief minister of Tamil Nadu, sir.
Thank you.
And that time, you'll realize that where the people are.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Saugodrai ji, yes.